Good afternoon, class 5. Welcome back to our video classes. So students, in the last class, in the last video class, we have completed up to skull. In your book, page number 2, skull we have completed, and the chapter is chapter number 1, the vertebrates, the skeletal system. And in the last class, we have completed up to skull. So in today's class, we are going to discuss the vertebral column. As we have completed this topic in our live classes, till I am going to explain this one, so you can get a revision of this topic. So first we will discuss the topic. Today's topic is vertebral column. Okay, the vertebral column, or it is said to be as backbone. It's also said to be as backbone. Okay, vertebral column, which is present inside the back side of our body, this portion, the middle, it is also said to be as the backbone. Okay, the backbone. Now, the skull attached to the vertebral column, which is also called the spine. The vertebral column forms the main axis of the skeleton. It is made up of 33 small and irregular shaped bones called vertebra, which are linked together. Okay, so the skull, our skull is attached to the backbone, the vertebral column, which is also called the spine, and the attachment of both the skull and the vertebral column is said to be as a spine. The vertebral column forms the main axis. It is forms the main axis of the skeleton of our body. The skeleton, it forms the main axis. And this vertebral column has total 33 bones. Okay, total 33 bones are there in our vertebral column. And they are irregular in shape. No regular shape is there. They are irregular in shape. And they are said to be as vertebra. They are said to be as vertebra, which is they are linked together. They are linked together like this. They are joined together. Okay, linked together. Now, although the vertebra are linked, they are not fused. They are linked together, but they are not fused. मतलब एक दूसरे से उलझे हुए नहीं है, fusion नहीं है उनका. They are only linked together. Okay. Now, the vertebra allow us to bend, twist, and stand upright. This vertebral column allows us to stand upright, to bend like this, and this is the vertebral column. I think I have completed this one, although we can take one revision, no issues there. And the delicate spinal cord, which is present here, it is protected by this vertebral column. Okay, so this is the function and the structure and the explanation of vertebral column. Now, the topic is ribcage. Our next topic is ribcage. What we are going to discuss? Ribcage. The front portion of our body. This is bone is said to be as ribcage. What it is said to be as ribcage. Ribs are flat. They are flat bones. Curved like this. They are curved, which are joined in the spine at the back. They are joined at the back and the breastbone also. As you can see in the book, the middle bone, which is present, it is said to be as the backbone. And these are the cane. The ribs were present, which is joined to the backbone and in the front to the breastbone. Okay, they are curved in shape. Total 12 pairs of rib cage is present. 12 pairs of bones were present. Among this, 10 pairs are attached to the backbone and in the front to the breast. But 2 pairs, as you can see in the book, the last 2 pairs are floating. Only they were attached to the vertebral column, but not in the front to the breastbone. So they are said to be as floating bones. They are said to be as floating bones, and this 10 pairs are said to be as breastbone. So this is our rib cage, and it protects the internal organ, delicate internal organ, heart and lung. Okay, so this is our rib cage. Now, and one more thing, rib cage expands when we breathe in or out the air. When we breathe, this rib cage expands in or out. Okay, so this is our rib cage. Now, turn the page. Arms and leg bones. Now we are going to discuss the topic. So each arms has three bones. They have three bones. First, three long bones you can say, and several short bones. Three main long bones and several short bones. So the upper arms have one long bone which is called as humerus. As you can see in the diagram, this portion of our body, the arms, is said to be as humerus. This is a long bone. And here two bones represent radius and ulna. One bone is said to be as radius and another bone is said to be as ulna. Okay, in the lower arm. This is the upper arm and this is the lower arm. Radius and ulna. This the upper arm bones is said to be as humerus and the lower arm bones is said to be as radius and ulna. Two bones were present. And this one is the collarbone. Okay, and this one is our shoulder blade. This one. This is our shoulder blade, this is our collar blade. Okay? So, the bones are connected at the elbow, the lower arms, and also several bones which form the wrist, palm, and fingers. And this next bones were present in our wrist. This bones were present in the wrist, the palms, and the finger. And several small bones were present. So, this together make the whole arm, is together make the hand, the upper limb of our body. Okay? So it is clear to you all, this is the upper limb of our body. Now student, come to the lower limb. Now again, one more thing is given in your book. The arms are connected to the shoulder blades. Now this arm is connected to the shoulder blades at the back and to the collarbone. Shoulder blade at the back and to the collarbone at the front. Now, these shoulder blades and the collar bones form the shoulder girdle. They together called as shoulder girdle. The backbone, the shoulder blade, and the front bone, collar bone, they both together call the shoulder girdle. The collar bones are turned connected to the upper part of the breastbone. Here in the middle, the breastbone is present as we have seen in the ribcage part, and this collar bone is attached to the upper part of the breastbone. Okay, so we have completed now. The upper limbs, it means arms. Now we are going to discuss the lower limbs, the leg. Now, the lower limbs or legs have three bones and several small bones, as same as the upper limb. Upper limb also has three long bones and lower limb also has three long bones and several small bones. So, the upper limbs, the longest bone is called the femur. The thigh bone, it is also said to be as the thigh bone. This is the femur, the longest bone. And the two bones in just below the knee, they are said to be as tibia and fibula. Fibula is the thinnest bone and the tibia is the strongest bone in our leg. In this tibia, the whole body, the body weight is in our tibia bones, which is present in our leg below the knees, our whole body weight. Okay. There are two types of bones are there, tibia and fibula. Now, tibia bears the weight of the entire body. As I told you, the bones tibia bear the whole weight of our body. The several bones in the lower leg, as in the arms, in the palm, wrist and the fingers, the bones, small bones are there. Likewise, in our leg also, the lower leg, the ankles and the toes have the several small bones. So students, this is arms and leg bones. So we have completed the skeleton. Okay, the skeleton bones, different types of bones were present in our body. One short activity is given in your book in page number 5, which I have explained to you earlier also. Then again, those who have not completed their work, please complete student and I am going to explain these things. the book. Here, after page number 132, all the parts of the skeleton is given. Here you can see all the parts of the skeleton is given. You have to cut out this page from your book with the help of the scissors. Now what you have to do, take a paper, green color paper, blue color paper from your scrapbook, whatever you want, and cut out the all the skeleton system from the page and paste it like a skeleton system. Here it has pasted very nicely. Now here you can see. Now this page is very well pasted. So like this you can paste here and label it also. The different bones of our skeleton system. Only this much is given in your activity and you have to do. Most of the students have done, but I think 5 or 6 students have not done their work. So students, please complete your work. Complete the activity. Okay? This activity is so effortless. There is no things needed. Turn the page, student. Now we are going to discuss a new topic. No, let's try is given in the book. One more topic is given, fact. A newborn baby has 300 bones. As I told you, as I explained you this thing, a newborn baby has 300 bones in their body. An adult has 206 bones. Later this baby becoming an adult, the bones, the small bones were so flexible, the baby body is so flexible, they join. When they get matured, becoming an adult, the bones, 300 bones become 206. Okay, this fact I have already explained you. Now, the fact, letters try is given in your book. Fill in the blanks. Letters try, the fill in the blanks is given in your book. We are going to discuss this one also. So, first one, A. The vertebral column protects the spinal cord. And if you have written the blood vessels, it is also correct. No issue, because it protects both. Now, the shoulder blade and dash from the shoulder griddle. What two bones to get from the shoulder griddle? I have explained you the collar bones. Okay, the answer is C-O-L-L-A-R-B-O-N-E-S, collar bones. Now, the third one. The lower leg is made of bones called dash and less. Dash and fibula. The lower bones are tibia and fibula. So the answer is T-I-B-I-A. Now the fourth one. The lower arm is made up of bones called radius and dash. The lower arm made up of bones called radius and dash. It is called radius and ulna. It is called radius and ulna. Okay. Now the fifth one. The dash protects the lungs and the heart. So the correct answer is ribcage protects the lungs and the heart. Correct answer is ribcage. So first answer is spinal cord or blood vessels. Second is collar bones. Third is tibia. Fourth is ulna. And fifth is rib cage. So this is your answer of the letters try. And the answer question number 2 and 3. What is a skeleton and what are carnal bones? Carnal bones are the bones which is flat and strong and which is present in our head. There are total 8 bones. And this bones is present in our skull. I have already given you the answer in the Gurukul app. And what is skeleton? The whole body which the whole bones were present in our body which say give shape, support and a proper framework. They are rigid. This is said to be as a skeleton. Okay, the answer I have already given you in the Gurukul app. Please go through it and write the answers. Okay everyone, so this topic, as I can say, the skeleton topic is completed. The different types of the components of bones, different types of bones were present in the human body. We have already completed. There are different types of bones like skull, vertebral column, rib cage, arms, and leg bones. The important bones which were present in our body, in the human body, we have already discussed it. Okay? Now we are going to start the joints, the topic joints. So I am giving you the introduction of topic joint. Okay. Just wait a minute. We can move some part of our body because of joints, है ना? Here, neck and shoulder joints, है ना? The wrist joint, the elbow joint, the knee joint. These joints help us the body to move. There are some joints that are present with the help of these joints. Some parts of our body can move easily, like joints of upper jaw and lower jaw. With the help of when this lower jaw moves, we are able to speak. At the joints, one fibrous structure tissue is present, which is said to be as ligament. I have told you about the ligament. Ligament is said to be as the lubricant, you can say. Okay? They are present in the bones and the joints, in between the joints. They make the joints flexible and our bones strong. Strength, मतलब उसको बहुत ज़्यादा immunity provide करता है, strength provide करता है, power to work in the whole of our life. Okay? Ligaments not only hold bones together but also help them to move. This ligament is present, not only holds the bones but they helps to move. When this ligament is present here in the joints, I am giving the example of elbow, we are able to move our joints very easily. It just makes very flexible and it provides power, strengthening energy to our bones. Okay, so this is joints. I am just giving you the short introduction of the joint. In the next class, in the next video class, I will explain you the whole different parts of joints that are present, like pivot joint, movable joint and immovable joint. In movable joint, hinge joint and ball and socket joint is present. In immovable joint, pivot joint and different types of joints were present. No, immovable joints are different, and in movable joints, hinge joints, pivot joints, ball and socket joints and griddle joints were present, gliding joints were present. So in the next class, we will discuss the different types of joints. Okay, till I am going to complete this video class, today's video class. Please students, whatever I have explained you, revise it and complete your book and along your copy. Complete your book and copy both. Okay student, thank you so much for today's class. See you all in the next class.